As a business owner or a leader of any group of people, we have to remember we're still human. And have you ever struggled with the fact that why won't my heart catch up with what I know? I know it happens to me and it's a struggle. And sometimes I want to separate my personal life from my business life and I want to operate there. And I want to believe that I'm a strong enough person and tough enough and I can separate my emotions out and not let them mess with me. But the reality is, that's just not a simple thing. And this week, I was reminded by a friend of mine, Daniel Whittington, who's the chancellor of Wizard Academy, and he also runs another YouTube channel called The Whiskey Vault. Some of you whiskey fans might know him. This email was so good, I texted him and I said, man, I gotta read this. Is it okay if I just read this to you, to my people? And he said, absolutely. So I want you to hear this, and I'm gonna read this email, but I want you to soak this in because this has to do with how hard it is sometimes for us to sink our mind and our heart and process through the healing in our life. Change is the ponderous task of shifting mountains. Give it time. Be patient with yourself and don't skip the hard parts. I think we fooled ourselves into believing everything moves faster in our modern world. We can know within minutes when something occurs on the opposite side of the planet. We can get on a plane and be on the other continent in hours. All the information our species has collected is dancing at our fingertips. The last few years have included major heart-wrenching changes in my life. To cope with it, I read books, I studied psychology and growth theories. I spoke to psychologists and shared late nights with friends in person and over the internet. This question kept floating through my head. I know all the things. How come my heart is still a wreck? How come I still feel like a hollowed out ship? Dr. Nick Grant was on the board of directors at Wizard Academy for over a decade and served as its chairman multiple times. He's also spent 40 years practicing as a counselor and psychologist, an author of several books, an instructor at University of Texas, and a world-renowned specialist in MBTI, which is Myers-Briggs. He also teaches at Wizard Academy, and I'm lucky enough to consider him a friend. And he's kind, not just brilliant. Like if you mixed Bill Nye with Mr. Rogers. I know, Dr. Nick, he is that. I asked him this question. His answer surprised me. My question for Dr. Grant was, why am I not changing at an emotional level at a pace that keeps up with my head knowledge and learning? He said, Daniel, the brain moves at the speed of sensory data and information, but the human heart moves at the speed of agriculture. He went on to explain that we as humans are fundamentally tied in time and seasons and the base patterns of the universe. Let me read that again. He went on to explain that we as humans are fundamentally tied into time and seasons and the base patterns of the universe. We can change access and speed of information, but psychologically, we move at the speed of seasons and the pace of change in the earth itself. It takes a minimum of 4 full seasons for a truly dramatic and extreme change to find a sense of landing and stillness in our heart. Even then, it's only if you're paying attention all the time to every single moment that it's speaking. A few weeks ago, I was in the vault and picked up a little bottle I didn't remember. There was a small squiggle of silver ink. A few weeks ago, I was in the vault and picked up a bottle I didn't remember. There was a small squiggle of silver ink on the side, so I tilted it sideways to read it. It was the signature of a friend of mine that donated the bottle to the whiskey vault. He passed away unexpectedly in November of last year. It's been 4 months. I've cried and mourned with friends. I've looked at old photos. I've read texts through. It's been 4 months. I've cried and mourned with friends. I've looked at old photos. I've read through our texts. It feels like a tender but healing wound now. The shock and surprise is being replaced with acceptance and fond memories. At least I thought it was. That bottle cracked me open like an egg. I discovered tears streaming down my face. At that moment, I realized I still wasn't ready. I'm not ready for him to never drink whiskey with me again. I'm not ready for him to not answer his email or pick up the phone or call me. I'm not ready. My heart isn't ready. I'm still moving at the speed of agriculture. And I need these moments to truly mourn. Don't skip the hard parts. I wanted to share this with you today because it was special to me. It was special to my wife, Catherine. And I'm hoping that it will speak to you. Because as you pursue the process of running a business, leading people, you're human. You bring your whole self to work every day, and you need to remember that. And when something happens in your life that's painful, hard, breaks your heart, tugs on it, give yourself the time. Don't pretend to be tough or hide it. You'll do yourself a much better service, and you'll do the people around you a service too.